Welcome to the Mount Morris Dam and Recreation Area, a project site managed by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Stretching 1,028 feet from end to end, the dam soars 250 feet above the Genesee River, standing guard over the lives and property of hundreds of thousands of people in western New York. Without the Mount Morris Dam, this area would be subject to periodic and sometimes massive flooding. Floods occur most frequently between late winter and early summer, fueled by prolonged rains, melting winter snow, or a combination of both. Taming the Genesee River and providing protection from the devastating floods are the primary purposes of the Mount Morris Dam. The Genesee River begins in the Allegheny Mountains of Pennsylvania, just south of the New York border. From its headwaters, the river flows north for 157 miles over steep, rugged terrain. The area is sparsely populated and devoted primarily to pasture and feed crops. Over that distance, the river drops approximately 2,000 feet in elevation and is fed by creeks and streams along the way. Its drainage basin covers about 2,500 square miles, or about 5% of New York State. As the Genesee River flows into Letchworth State Park, it descends in elevation more than 300 feet over three waterfalls at Portageville, approximately 17 miles upstream of the dam. This is the beginning of the Genesee River Gorge and the dam's reservoir. Here, the runoff from rainstorms and snowmelt is stored to prevent flooding of the lower basin, a flat plain approximately 3 miles wide. The rich soil in this area is devoted to grain, fruit, and vegetable farming, and to the raising of beef cattle. The land closer to Rochester supports heavy urban residential areas and commercial development, but beyond the city, the river descends another 230 feet over three more waterfalls before it flows into Lake Ontario. The Genesee Basin is comprised of 10 counties, with about 30 towns and villages and populations ranging from a few hundred to hundreds of thousands. With its large residential, commercial, and industrial areas, Rochester is the third largest city in the state after New York and Buffalo, and the only one located within the Genesee Basin. The Mount Morris Dam was built to protect nearly 70 river miles of downstream areas from the recurring and devastating floods brought on by the Genesee River. Records of flooding date to the early 1800s and show that almost every year brought some river overflow, causing damage in and around Rochester. On average, a major flood ravaged the Genesee River Valley every 7 years between 1865 and 1950. Each time, more than 17,000 acres of farmland were destroyed, and urban property suffered serious damage. The worst flood occurred in March of 1865, when a sudden thaw triggered the heaviest runoff in recorded history. The river channel through downtown Rochester was capable of handling only 40,000 cubic feet of water per second, but when the rising water finally crested, it was flowing at an estimated 54,000 cubic feet per second. Water covered store awnings, washed away roads and railway lines, and knocked down telegraph poles. In those days, the frequent floods cut off Rochester from the outside world. Although communications using telegraph were restored within a few days, it took months to rehabilitate the ravaged city and surrounding countryside. Years later, the United States Congress authorized the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Buffalo District to build the Mount Morris Dam Flood Control Project. The project was delayed by World War II, so it wasn't until 1948 that construction of the dam began. First, cofferdams were erected to direct the river away from the worksite. When about half of the lower section of the dam was complete, the cofferdams were removed, allowing work to continue. The dam is comprised of 22 sections called monoliths. The monoliths are independent tower-like concrete structures situated side by side across the gorge. This design allows the dam to hold strong while still allowing for small movement among the individual monoliths caused by expansion and contraction of the concrete. Movement and tilt of the monoliths are carefully monitored by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers around the clock, so that any unusual movement, such as uplift or overturning, could be quickly detected. Flatbed railroad cars were used to haul 750,000 cubic yards of wet concrete. Two large penstocks were built into the dam for possible future hydroelectric power generation. The Genesee River Act of 1989 protects the gorge from unnecessary flooding and safeguards rare ecological communities within the gorge. As a result, Mount Morris Dam does not maintain a reservoir and therefore can't produce hydropower, leaving the penstocks unused. The last bucket of concrete was poured on October 31, 1951, and even before construction was finished, Rochester newspapers reported that while under construction, the dam had already prevented thousands of dollars in damage. The formal dedication was held on June 26, 1952. The daily operation of such a massive structure is a big job. The Mount Morris Dam has an on-site team that performs daily inspections, general maintenance, and gate operations. Data that would detect any structural problems or abnormal conditions is collected 24 hours a day and analyzed by a team of engineers and operations staff. In-depth, periodic inspections and risk assessments are led by engineers from the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Buffalo District, who focus on the structural, geotechnical, electrical, and mechanical aspects of the structure. Depending on the risk, repairs and rehabilitation projects are recommended, and funds are requested from Congress. Teamwork, collaboration, and expertise are essential to ensure that the Mount Morris Dam operates as intended for years to come. The Mount Morris Dam is a concrete, gravity-type structure. Gravity dams use the weight of the material they're built with to resist the force of water stored behind the structure. As water pushes against the dam, the heavy concrete structure pushes into the ground and supports the dam. From a base measuring 213 feet thick, the dam tapers upward to a top width of 20 feet. Its operations tower is located in the east abutment. A 550-foot-wide spillway, or uncontrolled overflow section, is located at the center of the dam. The spillway is equipped to handle the flow of 320,000 cubic feet of water per second, which is equivalent to 2.4 million gallons of water flowing over the top of the dam every second. The dam's base contains 9 rectangular conduits to control water outflow through the dam. Each conduit measures 5 by 7 feet and is controlled by a vertical slide gate with a backup gate for emergency operation. The conduits function like sloping downspouts. There are no grates or other barriers to slow the flow of water. As water passes through the conduits of the dam, the river descends approximately 1 foot for every 10 feet, totaling a descent of approximately 25 feet from one side of the dam to the other. When the flow must be controlled, the slide gates inside the dam are lowered hydraulically to the appropriate level. The amount of water flowing through the conduits of the dam varies based on natural river conditions. When the river is at normal flow stages, the gates are open to allow water to freely pass through the dam. During the dry summer months, river flows can be as low as 100 cubic feet per second. When precipitation occurs, the river conditions change very quickly. As the river flow increases from precipitation, personnel begin closing gates to slow down the flow of the river, and that's when the upstream reservoir begins to fill. Once downstream conditions improve, gates are reopened and water is gradually released from the dam. About a half mile upstream, a debris boom stretches across the gorge. The boom catches the largest debris carried down the river. Each summer, when the basin is dry, workers with heavy equipment travel down into the gorge to grind and remove accumulated debris. Keeping debris away from the dam is important to prevent it from going through or over the dam and creating serious damage by jamming against bridges and other structures downstream. It also keeps the conduits clear. On the downstream side of the dam is a stilling basin, which serves both the spillway discharge and the conduits. Within the stilling basin, 2 rows of heavy concrete blocks, resembling large teeth, are submerged near the basin's downstream end to absorb some of the water's energy. As the term stilling implies, the basin's purpose is to slow the river's flow and protect areas downstream. The stilling basin lies between 2 training walls. These walls extend downstream from the dam, channeling the water away from the sides of the gorge to prevent erosion. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, along with the U.S. Geological Survey, use gauges to measure precipitation and water levels all along the Genesee River and its tributaries. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers hydrologists use the information to make decisions about dam operations, regulate the flow of the river, and reduce the risk of flooding downstream. Hydrologists calculate that it takes approximately 24 hours for a high water crest at Wellsville, near the Pennsylvania border, to reach the dam. Information on these gauges, coupled with forecast from the Northeast River and the National Weather Service, is provided to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Water Management Team in Buffalo, where decisions about regulating the river's flow are made. Those decisions are relayed to personnel on site at Mount Morris Dam. Water is held back from the dam and contained within the Genesee River Gorge. The reservoir stretches nearly 17 miles from Portageville through the St. Helena Valley and Mount Morris Canyon. Water flow through the dam has always been handled by the conduits, and the overflow spillway has never been used. But it came close in June of 1972 when Tropical Storm Agnes descended on the region. Agnes was a minimal hurricane when it left the Gulf of Mexico and headed north across the Florida Panhandle on June 19, 1972. The storm weakened to a tropical depression as it swept northeast through Georgia and the Carolinas, but rejuvenated near Norfolk, Virginia. Its moisture-laden Gulf atmosphere absorbed energy from the Atlantic Ocean, and later, as the storm veered westward into New York, it joined with another low-pressure system. The result was a rainstorm of a magnitude that occurs about once every 290 years. Agnes produced the most widespread flooding ever recorded in the northeastern United States. Before the storm finally ended on June 25th, up to 18 inches of rain had fallen in the Genesee River Valley, with the heaviest rainfall occurring over the upper basin, producing a flow of 90,000 cubic feet of water per second. The reservoir was filled to 96% capacity, coming within 4 feet of overtopping the spillway. Because the inflow exceeded the reservoir's capacity, it was necessary to release extra water from the dam for 2 days, causing some minor flood damage. Had that not been done, the spillway could have been overtopped, and dangerous debris could have swept downstream toward Rochester. While there was minimal damage from the excess flow, the situation could have been far worse had the dam not stood its ground. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers estimates that the dam prevented more than $200 million in property damage from Tropical Storm Agnes, primarily in the Rochester metropolitan area. The Mount Morris Dam was built at a total cost of $25 million in 1952. Though a price can't be placed on the value of protecting human life, the dam has saved billions of dollars in public and private property damages since it began operation. By all measures, building the dam was a wise investment. It continues to be a key asset in the protection and security of Western New York, without which much of the economic development in the Genesee River Valley would not have been possible. Here in the Genesee River Gorge, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers manages nearly 4,000 acres of forests and areas along the banks of the Genesee River. The gorge and surrounding lands constitute important habitat for a large variety of plants, insects, and animals ranging from beetles to black bears. Peregrine falcons and bald eagles call the canyon home. Surrounding forests host a diversity of warblers and other songbirds, and several great blue herons have rookeries in the area. It's why the Genesee River Gorge has earned designations as a state bird conservation and Audubon bird area. The Mount Morris Dam and Recreation Area offers recreational opportunities with picnic shelters, hiking, biking, playgrounds, and more. From here, you can connect to the Finger Lakes Trail, one of the premier hiking trails in New York State. From the Mount Morris Dam and Recreation Area, the trail follows the edge of the canyon through the Genesee Valley Greenway State Park, or south through Letchworth State Park. And for the adventurous visitor, the Genesee River is a designated Blue Way water trail that offers access for paddlers throughout the gorge and beyond. Along the Genesee River, there is something for everyone. If you are interested in learning more about the Mount Morris Dam, join a guided walking tour of the dam during summer months. The tour is ideal for visitors with an interest in engineering and natural resource management, or anyone who wants to learn more and get an up-close experience with this engineering marvel. From all of us at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, thank you for visiting the Mount Morris Dam and Recreation Area.